Our Macs tend to be a hub for all of our precious personal and unrecoverable information. Maybe it's your collection of family photos or years of archived work projects you've been saving. Now, what if one day all of that disappears? You sit down at your desk, click the power button, and nothing happens. Or maybe you get lucky and the screen comes on, but instead of booting into macOS, you get an icon of a flashing folder with a question mark inside. Either way, it's a bad sign for the survival of your data. That's why it's always better to be proactive and back up your data, because an event like this can occur at any time, and once it does, there's no going back. Luckily, Apple has an intuitive utility, so let's take a look at how to use it. To get started, you're going to need an external drive. I typically recommend getting a drive that's double your Mac's storage drive, or at least larger. This way there's enough space for a full copy of your computer and an equivalent amount of space for your history. To figure out what you have, click on the Apple menu, then go to About This Mac. In this window, click on the Storage tab. The first storage device should be called Macintosh HD, and that's your Mac's internal storage. Under the icon, you should see a storage capacity. In my case, I have 500 gigs in my computer, so I would preferably like to get a 1000 gigabyte external drive, but anything over 500 gigs should do the job. Now that you know the storage amount you're looking for, you also need to make sure you can connect to the drive to your computer. For an application like this, you're likely looking into USB external drives, but which style of USB should you be looking for? The oval modern USB Type-C or the classic rectangular USB Type-A? Unfortunately, this is not the easiest question to answer, so I'm going to try to help you through it. First, look at all the ports on your computer. You will likely find the rectangular USB-A connection, which is great because most external drives still come with this port. However, if you have a MacBook that only features USB Type-C, you may need to purchase a USB A to C adapter in order to connect the external drive to your MacBook. If none of this makes sense, that's okay, because I have linked a 1000 gigabyte external drive and a USB A to C adapter. If you get the two of those and plug everything in where it fits, you should be good to go. At this point, you should have everything you need to plug in your external drive to your Mac. Once it's plugged in, we can move to the next step, changing the drive format. This step is optional, but it will make your external drive more compatible with macOS. So use a keyboard shortcut, Command Space, to open Spotlight. In the search box that appears, you can type in whatever you're trying to find. In this case, we will search for Disk Utility, an app built into macOS that helps with drive management. In Disk Utility, you should see your drive appear under the external section of the left sidebar. If so, click on it and its information should populate the right panel. Next, click the Erase button on the toolbar. In the pop-up, you can give the drive a name like Macintosh Backup, then click the drop-down to change the drive format to APFS, then pause. Before clicking Erase, open the drive and confirm you don't have any data saved on that drive, because you're about to delete everything on it. But if you just unboxed a brand new drive, you shouldn't have anything to worry about, but I would still double-check just in case. Once you're ready to go, click Erase, and we will be ready to move to the next step. And if you have found this video helpful so far, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. At this point, you should have your drive connected to your Mac and have formatted it in the more macOS-friendly format, APFS. With all of that done, we can now open System Preferences and launch the Time Machine Preference pane. In big letters, you should see a button that says Select Disk in the middle of the window. Clicking this gives you a menu of all your connected external drives. From the list, double-click on your backup drive and it will run the first backup shortly after. And that's how you set up a Time Machine backup on macOS. From this time forward, your Mac will regularly back up to your external drive as long as it's connected. Speaking of being connected, here's another tip. Before you unplug any external drive, whether it's a USB thumb drive or your backup drive, make sure you eject it from macOS before simply unplugging it. This ensures macOS is finished with it before it gets disconnected. It may be right in the middle of a backup that needs to be stopped, or you may have a file open that's saved on that flash drive. So click the Finder icon on the dock to open a Finder window and scroll down to the Locations group on the sidebar. Now find the drive you want to unplug and click the Eject button. Once it disappears from the list, it should be safe to unplug. Getting back on topic, the time machine starts by taking a full copy of your computer, then every hour it takes a copy of your changes and keeps them for a day. After a day, those hourly backups are condensed into days, the days are condensed into months, and the months are condensed into weeks. All of this is kept until your backup fills up. At that point, your older backups are deleted to make more space for the latest updates. Now, with a copy of your data safely on another drive, if your Mac fails, you can try to repair it or get a new one, plug in your current backup drive, restore from a time machine backup, and be up and running in no time. But it's also useful for recovering files you edited or deleted by accident. If you go back into the Time Machine Preference pane, you can toggle Show Time Machine in the menu bar. In the new drop-down menu on the menu bar, you can see the last time your Mac backed up and even run a manual backup. At the bottom of the list, it gives you quick access back to the Time Machine Preference pane, but what I want to point out to you is the Enter Time Machine option. This will bring a Finder window front and center, allowing you to travel days, weeks, and even months into the past while letting you navigate through what your files and folders looked like on that day. Then if you find your missing file, you can select it and restore, which will bring it back into the modern day, placing it in the same folder as it was back then. And that's Apple's built-in backup utility, Time Machine. An intuitive way to efficiently back up your computer without having to think about it, but reliable when you need it, like when a computer fails or when you delete a file by accident. Thanks for watching. Do you have any horror stories about a time you lost your data? Let me know in the comments below. Also, while down there, check out the helpful links in the description for more on this topic and from Apple Guide. Once again, thank you so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one.